first of all, they're called the Damper Dance. And if you're a little confused, you may have heard of the term Dapper Dan before. And this is a play on that. In German, when we're playing music, especially by Mahler or any German composers like that, there'll be a term saying mit Dumper, which means with mute. And mute is this little, this thing right here, this little cone. And that changes the sound. So Dampfer Dance is a play on Dapper Dan, but using that musical term for mute. But also, they have the number four, Damp4, F-O-U-R, instead of normally it's F-E-R. And F-O-U-R, meaning there's four of them. So it's a very witty, you know, triple entendre, I guess. Now, let me just talk a little bit about the four folks up here. Over on the far right is Tim Moy, and yes. And Tim graduated from Cal State Fullerton and then went on to Boston University and got his master's degree in horn performance there. Alexander Delperdang, he is currently a student at Cal State Fullerton. Your recital is coming up on?
April 22nd.
April 22nd, big horn recital, excellent. And then we have Danny Ward, who is playing. He just got his master's about a year ago, 2 years ago, from Cal State Long Beach. And then we have Patrick Williams, who, yes, and you also got your master's degree from Cal State Long Beach at the same time as?
1 year.
Oh, okay, got it, 1 year. So there you go, so this is the Damper Dance! And they're going to be this piece, this is the other, we swapped their pieces. So this is the Waltzing Matilda, which is a famous Australian tune. And this piece was arranged, this arrangement was done for Sarah Willis, who plays fourth horn in the Berlin Philharmonic. And Sarah Willis is a monster low French horn player. And so this piece, because she asked for it to be arranged, it features the low horn. And so Patrick's going to be rocking the Sarah Willis low horn part. So pretend he's Sarah Willis.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
it's westerns, and westerns always have what?
Horses.
To be a western, what does it need?
Horses.
It needs a horse. So they called it Oater. I don't get it, but that's a lot. Before we play the piece, I want to thank the band. And I want you to understand that they came from all over Southern California. And I'm going to, instead of announcing everybody's name, I'm just going to tell you who had to drive the farthest. So when I say your city, your county, rather, I want you to wave to the audience. Okay, you want to hear where these guys came from?
Yes.
Let's start from the furthest. I think it's further than San Diego. The valley. From Northridge, we have Roger. 2.5 hour drive. From San Diego, anybody? Right here? Right there. From Los Angeles, did we skip anybody? Los Angeles. By themselves, I just want everybody from Cal State Fullerton to wave at them. Cal State Fullerton. Wave. All in the back row, all those handsome young guys. Okay, and everybody else from Orange County? Now we get San Bernardino. Finally, Riverside. Where were you from? Claremont. Well, you didn't read.
LA County.
Yeah. So there we are. You know, my dad passed recently, but had his ceremony of life. We played westerns because we had a large horn gathering and he loved westerns. My brother always asked him, why do you like the westerns so much? Because the horn parts. He was a horn player. And so when I was growing up, he gave me a hose horn when I was 10, and then he put the westerns on so I could hear what it's supposed to sound like. So I love westerns. My wife doesn't let me watch them too often, so I do it in the other room over there. So this last piece is a medley of westerns. Some of the titles are How the West Was Won, High Noon, and The Magnificent Seven. There's actually 5 Western movies in the soundtrack. And then we're going to call it a day. So this is the Oater Festival.
Thank you. Thank you.